Hello guys, this is Raymond from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some product announcements scheduled for this week. One of the more low-profile launches of this week is going to be Infinix Note 10 series. The Infinix Note 10 and Infinix Note 10 Pro will be unveiled on June 7th. Bearing a few minor differences here and there, both smartphones offer near-identical specifications. Starting with the Infinix Note 10 Pro, we get a colossal 6.9-inch Full HD Plus IPC LCD panel with a refresh rate of 90Hz, a 5000mAh battery that supports a 33W fast charging. Its quad camera array has a 64MP wide-angle lens, 8MP of ultra wide angle lens and a 2MP of monochrome lens and a 2MP of depth sensor. A 16MP module is earmarked for the selfie and all that. Lastly, the Infinix Note 10 Pro runs on a MediaTek Helio G95 processor coupled with the 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. The lower spaced Infinix Note 10 compromises on the camera with this smartphone shipping with 3 sensors, 48MP of ultra wide angle sensor and a 2MP of monochrome lens and a 2MP of depth sensor. The other downgrade involves a MediaTek Helio G85 powering the smartphone. Lastly, the battery charging capacity is moved from 33W to 18W. The Infinix Note 10 sale starts from 13 June and the prices for the 4GB RAM and 64GB is available for ₹10,999 and 6GB RAM and 128GB storage is available for ₹11,999. And the price for the Redmi Note 10 Pro is for 8GB RAM and 256GB storage, it comes for ₹16,999 Indian rupees. The pre-order starts from 13th of June. From the smartwatches segment, Flipkart presents the Firebolt DT Store to offer you the cutting-edge wearable device that can offer you convenient style and the flexibility to use it the way you want. This Firebolt watch store has a Firebolt smartwatch dock, which is a fully touch device with a Bluetooth calling facility. Carrying your smartphone everywhere may not always be a convenient, thus in situations like this, the Firebolt dock can be a great use. Using the Bluetooth calling function, you can answer as well as make calls. So with this smartwatch, you don't want to miss any important call or need to take out your phone from your pocket or bag to get annoyed by a scam call. So you can also check call history and sync your phone's speed dial contact on the smartwatch. When it comes to its build, it has a 3D HD display on a full metallic body to make your rough and tough lifestyle. It also has a SpO2 tracker, blood pressure and a heart rate monitor, as well as various sport modes to track your health and fitness. The price for the Firebolt smartwatch will be available at ₹4,499. And next is Poco will unveil its low-cost 5G offering. The Poco M3 Pro will also be launching on June 8th. We'll try to steal the IQ's thunder. The Poco phone comes with a 6.5-inch Full HD Plus panel clocked at 90Hz refresh rate. It comes with a MediaTek Dimensity 700 processor. Along with that, it comes with a 6GB RAM and 128GB storage with UFS 2.2 storage. The smartphone draws power from a 5000mAh battery that supports fast charging at 18W. The Poco M3 Pro 5G has a triple camera at the back with a 48MP primary sensor, 2MP of depth unit and a 2MP of macro sensor. There is an 8MP snapper on the front for selfies and video chat. Connectivity features include a 5G dual band 4G, dual band Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 5.0, GPS and USB Type-C port for charging and data transfer. This device weighs 190 grams and has a 3.5mm headphone jack, IR blaster, NFC and high resolution audio. And next in the list, we have IQ Z3 5G will be launching in India on Tuesday, June 8th. It ships with a 6.58-inch Full HD Plus LCD panel clocked at 120Hz. It is also a HDR 10 Plus compliant and covers a 96% of the NTSC color gamut. It is slated to be the first ever smartphone in India to use a Qualcomm Snapdragon 768G processor. Its 4400mAh battery supports a 55W fast charging. The IQ Z3 5G's triple camera consisting of 64MP Samsung ISOCELL GW3 primary sensor and a 8MP of ultra wide angle lens and a 2MP of depth sensor. A 16MP of front facing camera handles selfies and video chats. Lastly, a side mounted fingerprint sensor is included for biometric authentication. And from the earbud segments, we gonna see Sony's WF-1000XM series is touted as one of the best earbuds you can buy. It tends to keep the track record when it announced the WF-1000XM4 on Wednesday, June 9. The pair of earbuds is expected to come with significant improvements over its predecessor along with an increase in price. A promo video leaked a week ago and it gives us an early look at the features of the earbuds. OnePlus Nord CE 5G will be launched in India on June 10th. It features a 6.43 inch Full HD Plus AMOLED panel clocked at 90Hz. OnePlus has also thrown an in-display fingerprint sensor, and it comes with a Snapdragon 750G chipset coupled with up to 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. Its triple camera array will be spearheaded by a 64MP OmniVision sensor, an 8MP ultra-wide lens, and a 2MP of depth sensor will assist it. The front camera will be having a 16MP sensor for selfies and video calling. Lastly, the OnePlus Nord CE 5G will run on a 4500mAh battery that supports 30W fast charging. Along with the OnePlus Nord CE 5G, OnePlus will also debut its new smart TVs in India at the event on June 10th. The company has confirmed the release of its U1 series in India. It has also listed some of the key features via microsite on Flipkart. According to the leaks, it will come in 50-inch, 55-inch and 65-inch screen sizes. The 65-inch variant will have 4 speakers, whereas other 2 will have 2 speakers each. All 3 screens will come with a 4K resolution support. One display features include a 93% DCI P3 color gamut. And this new OnePlus TV will use DLED, that is direct LED panels, with a 60Hz refresh rate and have a 300 nits brightness. The upcoming OnePlus TVs will also have a blue light mode along with a new live TV section in Oxygen OS TV that OnePlus silently introduced with the OnePlus TV 40Y1. In terms of audio, the devices will come with a 30W speaker with Dolby Atmos and a Dolby Audio. It will also come with an Android 10 TV and support a Google Assistant with smart voice control. The TV will also support OnePlus proprietary Oxygen Play content discovery platform. OnePlus might also bundle a plug-and-play webcam for the video calls with a 65-inch model. The webcam will offer fixed focus, a USB Type-C port, and a physical camera shutter. From the Cisco is launching their new smartwatches called Cisco Bolt. It comes with the features like female health tracking, smart notifications, 100+ versatile watch faces, weather report, hand sanitizing reminder, water reminder, multi-sport mode, SPO2 monitoring, health tracking, music and camera control, and sedentary alerts. It comes with a 1.28 inch IPS LCD high resolution touchscreen display. It has a 10 days battery life. It comes with a IP68 water resistant. Vivo is all set to launch its new smartphone, the Vivo Y73, in India on June 10. The company has officially confirmed the launch date of this new smartphone through its official Twitter handle. The launch of the Vivo Y73 was first teased by Vivo's India director Nipun Maurya a few days back. The Vivo Y73 is expected to feature a 6.44 inch AMOLED display. The phone is supposed to come with an in-display fingerprint sensor. Under the hood, the Y73 might be powered by an octa-core Helio G95 processor. The Tecno is all set to launch a new smartphone dubbed as a Tecno Spark 7T in India on June 11. The company has recently confirmed the launch of this new handset for the Indian market through its official Twitter handle. The Tecno Spark 7T will be an Amazon exclusive device, as an e-commerce giant has already made the microsite of the Spark 7T live ahead of the launch. The Tecno Spark 7T could be the cheapest handset to launch with a 48MP camera sensor. The phone is confirmed to sport a 6.5 inch display and it will pack a 6,000mAh battery. Apart from confirming the specification, Microsite published and Amazon also revealed the Spark 7T design ahead of the launch. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.